sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. 'Twas grace that brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be with all of you. In the waters of baptism, Dolores died with Christ, and she rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. O God, to whom mercy and forgiveness belong, hear our prayers on behalf of your servant Dolores, whom you have called out of this world, and because she put her hope and trust in you, command that she be carried safely home to heaven and come to enjoy your eternal reward. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, but their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet it is their hope, full of immortality, chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. My shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me, he revives my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. leads me along the right path for the sake of his name. Though I should walk in the valley of the shadow of death, no evil would I fear, for you are with me. Your crook and your staff will give me comfort. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. You have prepared a table before me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell for length of days unending. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that they may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. For we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds, to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Where I am, you also shall be. These words that we hear in the gospel today are no empty words, but rather they are a promise made to us by Jesus Christ. It's a promise made to you and to me, and today we reflect in a special way how that promise is also made to Dolores. That promise is our cause for hope and our reason for joy, even in the midst of loss. This promise means that our sorrow at the passing of a loved one does not have the last word, but rather that sadness can be tinged by hope. We've gathered here today in commemoration of Dolores' life, and in order to pray for her eternal rest and for our own consolation. But we know that her life is not over just because she has left this world. The faithful promises of God inspire us to confidence that Dolores now lives with Christ, who is the very fullness of life itself. This is what Jesus promises when he says that he is going to prepare a place for us. These are beautiful words. They mean that God has a plan for each one of us, and that our entrance into his presence is somehow already being provided for, that in some mysterious but powerful way, we spend this life in preparation for the life to come. For Dolores, I think they're also very appropriate words. Every Christian lives her life as a reflection of the gospel in some way, and Dolores was no exception. As you shared, Dolores came to this country as a teenager, and she learned English on her own. In a very literal way, she knew what it meant to have to prepare a new life for herself. And yet you also noted her dedication to acts of care for those whom she loved, particularly through her cooking. Most of all, she had a devotion to our Blessed Mother, especially under the title of Our Lady of Guadalupe. As Christians, we believe that we have a God who truly does care for us, and we are blessed by those like Dolores, who showed us a glimpse of that loving care in this life. And so as we pray this morning, we lift Dolores up to the Lord. Let us commend her to the care of the Mother of Christ, who is also our Mother. And let us pray that she will enter the dwelling place of the Father, where nothing will ever separate her or us from the eternal love of Jesus Christ. Please rise. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead, and so with confidence we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
Please respond. Hear our prayer. In baptism, Dolores received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Our sister Dolores was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Dolores seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that can come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen and love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer this day for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
Oh.
Please rise and pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands, praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Dolores, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and David our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Dolores, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Agnus Dei, qui tuis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tuis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace.
You may kneel or be seated. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. So a brief note on the reception of Holy Communion. If you're not comfortable receiving Holy Communion, or if you're not used to receiving Holy Communion, please know that you're still welcome to come forward in the communion line, but you can receive a blessing instead. Just cross your arms and an X over your chest like this. I'd be very happy to impart to you that blessing.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels is given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. And hold you, hold you.
Please rise. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Dolores may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
O loving God, we send your daughter home to you, home to a place of everlasting love, to join there with the angel choirs and blessed saints, and to behold your glorious holy face. Receive her soul and let eternal light shine. Eternal light forever on her soul, so she may live forever in your dwelling place, and be at rest in peace until we meet her.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Dolores in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I ask you to follow us out in the procession, as we'll have some prayers of committal in the entryway of the church. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
Amen.
consider all the works thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul,